and welcome to First Time Mumbai. I'm Anisha Natarajan, and let's begin with the good news first. All cities, including Noida and Greater Noida, have been brought under the credit link subsidy scheme for the middle income group, MIG, with effect, and this is important to remember, with effect from January 1st, 2017. So if your income is up to 18 lakh rupees per annum and you've bought a home or booked a flat in these cities or any other in India, you can go back to your home loan bank lender and avail the subsidy. On that note, let's also welcome our expert, Sameer Jasuja, on the show. Sameer, welcome.
Thank you so much.
All right, let's take a look at the key markets we will be covering on FTHP. The first market is Mumbai's Ville Parle in a budget of 1.5 crore rupees. We have a sell question from Gurgaon or Southern Peripheral Road also, whether it's a good time to or right time to sell. Pune's Undri micro market will be in focus. Best picks in a budget of a crore plus. Also, we head to Noida Extension. And what can you buy here if you've got 60 lakh rupees as your budget? We've got a question from Thane Balkum in a budget of 95 lakh rupees. Top picks in real estate. We also go from west right up to east of India, Kolkata, Rajpur. That's a modest budget of 15 to 20 lakhs, truly what the government calls affordable homes. What can you buy? But our first caller is waiting by patiently, Mr. Abhay Parab. Mr. Parab, thank you so much for joining us, sir. How can we help you?
Actually, my requirement is 1.52 crore is there, and 1.52 2 BHK is my requirement. And I want ready to move house in Ville Parle East area.
Okay, so Ville Parle is a market you've chosen. Sameer, 1.5 to 2 crore rupees, I think that's a fair budget. What can we give him, 1 BHK, 2 BHK, and what's available in this market?
When it comes to Mumbai, and especially a micro market like Ville Parle, which is an old established micro market, what I would like to call it, very well located as well in the context of Mumbai, since it's expanded a lot, I would say you'll only be able to manage a 1 BHK here. It gets a location rating of 7. It's always going to be an undersupplied micro market, yet we've got some options. Some sporadic developments keep on happening, either through redevelopment schemes or some old plot being broken down into building into new apartments. So options will always be there, but limited. J. Usha CHSL is the first recommendation by A1 Construction. The project has been ready since 2016, available in the resale market, trading between 31,500 to 32,000 rupees a square foot. Then we have Anupam CHS by Khandelwal Group. This rate is on carpet area, so around 40,000 rupees a square foot. It's been ready since 2016, again in the resale market. And lastly, we have Vrindavan by Chaitanya Group. This is again carpet area rates, 40,000 rupees, 1 BHK, size of about 450 square feet is what you'll be able to manage. It's been ready since 2 years and it's available in the resale market.
All right. So, well, sir, availability is only, some of these projects is only in the resale market. Ville Parle, one of the best located markets of Mumbai. Here are the three projects you can look at. 1 BHK is all that we'll be able to give you in that budget. So Prop Equity Data has shortlisted Jalusha CHSL by AI Constructions, Anupam CHS by Khandelwal Group, and Vrindavan by Chaitanya Group. All right, let's head to up north. Gurugram. Pavan Kohli has sent us an email. Is it the right time to sell a 4-bedroom house, 2,400 square feet, ready-made with all interiors in Sector 70, Gurugram? I'm expecting 2 crores. I'm an NRI. Please advise. If I'm not mistaken, Sameer, this is an area which really hasn't been able to take off in terms of physical infrastructure, isn't it, between NPR and SPR. So will he find a buyer at this in this market at this price?
Unfortunately, Manisha, you're absolutely right. This is an adequately supplied market, even for ready supply. Gets a location rating of 5 to 5.5. This micro market hasn't done too well, and there's a lot of issues, especially with respect to even Unitech projects being stalled over there. Not too much development happening here. The current price of the project that you have got, and if you'd like to sell today, will be 1.2 crore. So it's a far cry from 2 crores. You'll have to really wait for a couple of years at least to be able to get that kind of a price point, provided all the social infrastructure and the physical infrastructure catches up over there, which Huda has promised, but it has to be seen on the ground.
All right. So, well, you're saying it's a hold or sell, but sell at a lower expectation, price expectation.
Yeah, Manisha, you know, the price point is 1.2 crores. It's, you know, you're really neither here nor there with respect to this. I would say hold on to the property for a bit more. Let some better infrastructure get developed in SPR and then maybe look at an exit and maybe you can get a better price point. But don't have too many high expectations out of this area. That don't think that this area is going to appreciate 15 to 20% on a year-on-year basis, given the fact that the pricing is still very attractive, but still it's not going to appreciate that quickly.
Okay. All right. So, well, Pawan, that's the recommendation coming in from Sameer Jasuja, that hold on to the property at this moment. You know, what you will get from selling this property is so far away from your ask price that you might as well wait it out and hope for better infrastructure to come up. Let's pick up this next email from Anu. She asks, I want to purchase a 3 BHK Noida extension. My budget is 60 lakh and I want a ready to move in or a possession within this year. I visited some projects and she's given some names, Sameer. Divyansh Flora, Apex Gold Course and Aishwarya. Over to you.
So, Noida Extension is a micro market which is an affordable to mid-market. It's got a lot of supply over there. A lot of developers launched projects left, right and center, and that's why it's really had a negative appreciation. Price points still continue to be very attractive at around 3,200 rupees a square foot on the weighted average price scale. Location rating is 5 because the social and physical infrastructure is still under construction really, and it's in the pipeline. It has to still come up properly. As I mentioned, it's an oversupplied micro market. The project of Divyansh Flora that you shortlisted by Gore is a project that you can go ahead with. It's by Divyansh Infracon actually, but it's in Gore City 2. It's trading at 3,200 rupees a square foot. It's a ready to move in project. Aishwaryam Towers is also okay. Wallrock Infratech is the developer. Sector 16C, it's under construction right now, getting ready next year. And lastly, Apex Golf Avenue by Apex Wilcon. It's in Tech Zone 4. It's not in Sector 16C. Again, expected to get ready next year and it's under construction. Any of these three projects are okay, but just keep in mind appreciation is not going to happen for some time over here.
All right. So an overcrowded market, but well, it's a go ahead on the projects at least shortlisted. Divyansh Flora by Gore City, in Gore City 2 by Divyansh Infracon, Aishwaryam Tower, Gore City 2 by Wallrock Infratech and Apex Golf Avenue by Apex Buildcon. We've got our next caller online as well, Hussein Penta. Mr. Penta, how can we help you, sir?
Hi, you know, I have purchased 2 BHK compact at Highland Heaven in Thane. It was bought few days before demonetization. I was supposed to get the possession in December, but somehow it has been delayed for another 6 months. So I just want to know, is it a good buy as per location? Will there be any price appreciation? As I know, will there be many developments in Thane, like metro will be coming up and also bullet train will pass through Thane. So...
yeah. Well, Thane has got re-rated, if I'm not mistaken. Sameer, Balcom is the market that he's speaking about. You know, the property is with him. He bought it, like he said, before demonetization, and there has been a market which has simply not gone anywhere post-demonetization. In some markets, the value of the real estate has also come down a little bit. What's your suggestion?
If I'm correct, he bought it way pre-demonetization in Jan 2010. The price point was about 4,800 rupees a square foot, and the current price in about 8 years is about 8,500 rupees a square foot. So the project has not done too badly. I don't know which price point, which timeline he exactly entered, Mr. Hussain. Over the last 2-3 years, price appreciation has been very limited. Before that, it was quite rapid. It's an adequately supplied micro market with a location rating of 6.5. It's in the better part of Balcom, and there are other well-branded developers over here now that are launching projects. You know, price appreciation is going to be limited. It's a good project to hold. It's it'll give you a rental of about 15 to 18,000 rupees, excluding maintenance. you know, as far as looking at an exit is concerned, because last 3 years has not witnessed too much price appreciation, maybe you can give it a year or two more. Maybe there's better pricing that you will be able to get and fetch for this apartment, and then maybe you can look at an exit.
All right, so Highland Haven, Balcom at Thane is a hold as of now. Like, in fact, Mr. Hussain himself mentioned, Sameer, some of the future infrastructure projects which are likely to make connectivity better. So hold for now, and you could see some amount of traction when it comes to price appreciation. All right, let's take this email, and this one comes from Shubham Shinde. He asks, we are in the process of buying a 3BHK flat. Built-up area is 1,820 square feet, carpet around 1,400 square feet. In 24K, Allura Hills and Dale Society, Undri, Pune, for 1.1 crore inclusive. So I think he just needs your verdict, Sameer, whether this is the right decision to buy a flat in this area for this price, and what could be the future price appreciation prospect.
So, Manisha, the weighted average price of this market is about 5,800 rupees a square foot for luxury projects. What Mr. Shubham has shortlisted is a luxury project over there. So it's in ballpark, the same price point of the weighted average price of the market. The location rating of this micro market is about 6. It's adequately supplied micro market. The secondary market is pretty active over here for even ready-to-move-in projects. Undri is still in the development stage. There's a lot of availability of land bank. There are good reputed developers coming here. Proximity to IT hubs makes it an attractive micro market. So you can go ahead with 24K Allure. It's a luxury project. It's been ready since 2013, so nothing really to worry about. Available in the resale market. Naiti Etios Phase 2 is another good project. Naiti is a very big developer out of Undri region. This project's been ready since 2015 and available in the resale market. And lastly, we have a Godrej project over here, Godrej Horizon by Godrej Properties, trading at roughly the same price point as the other developers. And it's the newest project out of the three. It's been ready since 2017. And this is directly available for the developer, so maybe you can negotiate a little bit over here as well.
All right, so Shubham, 24K Allure by Kolte Patil gets a go-ahead. Niyati Etios Phase 2 by Niyati Group and Godrej Horizon by Godrej Properties are other choices offered by PropEquity or have come up in PropEquity shortlist. Take a look at these, but price appreciation, have some patience. Anybody buying real estate today will have to have patience when it comes to price appreciation. Reminder to all of you, send us your question at home at nw18.com. We'll be back to cover many more questions. We'll take you to Ahmedabad and Kolkata, so stay tuned.